A dramatic escalation in international tensions is obvious when you look at the news, but look at the price of oil, barely moved. A very unusual occurrence considering the event that took place. But this is the new volatility suppression that is a direct result of central bank intervention. Nothing bad can ever happen when Daddy Fed is here to save us. What the world needs least right now is another expansion of the empire, and yet, with an increased budget and half of the region completely decimated, new territory needs to be leveled. You came here for the truth, so let me unveil that for you. Obviously, we're going to talk about what's going on here in this particular region. I'm going to be tiptoeing around the subject simply because it's too much for this platform. I can't even use certain words. I can't talk about certain topics, but I want to give you as much information as I possibly can simply because I don't want to ignore it. It is very important, and I want to be as transparent as I possibly can given the terms that we're dealing with here. Whether we're looking at WTI or Brent, all I'm trying to show you here is that the price did not spike nearly as much as I would have thought. It went up a few percent, and that's basically the end of that. As you look towards the bottom, breaking news, oil prices climb higher on huge crude inventory draw. They're not even highlighting the actual events that took place. It seems to be muted, at least in the impact it had in the markets themselves. We'll see what happens on Monday as the markets resume, and we'll see what happens with the trading. The tensions have certainly increased. We'll talk more about that in a second, but this was the one thing that I wanted to talk about first, because the impact of, let's say, a closure of the Strait of Hormuz, for instance, could put that region and, of course, the price of oil in disarray. Nobody's going to know what the price is at. Nobody's going to know the extent of it, and it will be more than troublesome. There's no doubt about it. I know a lot of people will say that, don't worry, the U.S. is energy independent and so on. Well, number one, it's more than the U.S. you got to worry about. And number two, look at the U.S. producers of oil and how many of them have gone bankrupt or are on the verge of bankruptcy. Doesn't seem to be so profitable after all. If you want to know what's going on right now today, there are two dates that you need to be looking into. Number one, 1953. The declassified information that's available tells you who is really in control. Fast forward to 1979. The process continues. Why is it that individuals believe, for some strange reason, that what happened at a certain point in time won't just happen again and again and again? Those that control the governments will never let up. They will never actually allow anything to happen outside of their control. Anybody who opposes the globalist elite will be eliminated. I should just repeat myself once again. Anyone who opposes the globalist elite will be eliminated. There are no exceptions. So you could definitely check out number one, the declassified information from 1953, as well as the events that led up to 1979. There's a lot that people do not understand about it. Definitely take the time, maybe not even read a few books on the topic, but if you just do some searches, I'm sure that you'll be able to find what I believe to be integral to understanding the wider picture here. If you remember, these three countries, including China and Russia, had these joint naval drills, and that was just prior. I mean, this was at the end of December, and they were trying to flex, and certainly it didn't end up so good for them. This is just what I wanted to introduce this particular topic with, because you have seen certain countries condemning what has happened. France, Russia, and China being three of them. Condemning is one thing, but taking action is another. What exactly will they do? We know that the partnership between China and the United States is extremely important. Despite the fact that they seem like they're enemies, they seem like they're against each other, they both need each other. They're both in a partnership where China can be the manufacturing base for the United States. The United States is a major consumer of so much that China produces. China can keep their people working. They could expand on their own terms. It's mutually beneficial. in a limited sense. But of course, if things heat up, if things become sour between these two countries, if they're so integrated, it becomes very difficult and dangerous to pull these two apart. So I am very interested to see what happens between particularly China and Russia and the United States. What exactly are they going to do? Are they just going to make a statement and say what you did was wrong, or are they going to step in? Do you remember back in 2012 with the Stuxnet? Well, Stuxnet happened to be another event that largely was swept aside by the media. Yes, they did cover it, but nobody said, what about sovereignty? What about coming to the table and discussing what's going to happen and what's been going on? So the events that we are seeing today are simply a continuation of the military-industrial complex and what they do. They run the show. They decide what's going to happen and what doesn't happen. The orders that are given are not going to come from an individual like this guy. That is completely and utterly absurd. And then we had the nuclear scientists, I think it was four of them in a relatively short period of time, that happened to be disappeared. Coincidence? I think not. So the activities here have been going on for a while. That's all I'm trying to say. It wasn't just one event. It's been happening. And the whole time, this particular country has basically been taking it. They never put anything out there into the media saying, you did this, you did this. I guess they didn't have the proof. Or quite frankly, the puppet masters are just saying, shut up. I don't know, I'm speculating, but it's just really unusual to see one country just taking an absolute beating on one side and not really speaking up about it. This article here out of Business Insider is talking about the seven aerospace and defense stocks getting a huge boost from this particular strike. And you know what this is all about. This is big business, multi-billion dollars, and when you look at it over a period of years, we're seeing trillions of dollars being spent on this. They don't even know what the missions are. They don't even know what's happening. But of course, you got those people going in and doing their thing. Despite all of that fake so-called proof to go into Iraq, and still, they are pushing their way through, the same people that are responsible for what has been going on for all these years, and the same group is doing it again. I don't know what's going on. I don't know the insider information. I just see the patterns repeating, and just like in the financial industry, it's supposed to set off some warning signals. Unfortunately, people just believe whatever they're told at face value, and that's the way it goes. If you found the video informative, give me a thumbs up. If you hate it, give me a thumbs down. Check out my free e-course on Amazon, theamazongps.com. If you want to know information about the financial industry, I have two books. They're available in the description. And if you want to know about solutions, I have this playlist that's called How To and Solutions, which is hours of content to help you out. Check it out. I'll see you there.